A very good afternoon to everyone.
Good afternoon to you too, ma'am.
See, if we see the curriculum of B.Ed, the 50% weightage is given for the practical. Just recall the syllabus, or you can say the curriculum of the first year B.Ed. Total 7 theory papers are there, and remaining part is the practical part, right? So if we see total 7 papers means 80 marks for the external exam. So 8 into 7 total 540 marks are there for the theory work, we can say, and the remaining marks for the practical work. So see how much the practical work is important, because the teaching, it is a professional course. Okay. Before moving away, I would like to know the difference between practice teaching and internship program. Yes. Can anyone try to tell me what is the difference between the practice teaching and internship program? Yes.
Ma'am, in practice teaching, we are taking specific classes only, but internship, we have to a staff of the school, yeah, whatever they are doing, we should do in internship.
Okay. Yeah, curricular and co-curricular.
We have
activity.
To behave like, yes, a member of that school.
School, yeah.
In, okay, internship.
Okay, good. All answers were correct.
Means it's like a full-time work for us,
yes,
in internship.
Very true. See, if we see, it is regarding the exposure. In the practice teaching, you are getting exposure of teaching only. So actual physical teaching in the classroom, you are getting direct experience. If we see, just recall the previous lessons, except practice teaching and internship, even in the first year also, you have completed your micro teaching, your team teaching, your technology-based teaching, your MOTs. So all these lessons you took in the simulation condition, and only the practice teaching and whatever lessons included in the first year of internship program, that lessons you took in the actually in the physical classes. Okay, so that is the different. The basic difference is between the practice teaching and internship. It is regarding the exposure, because as compared to practice teaching, you are getting more exposure in the internship program. So what kind of exposure, yes, you are getting in internship program? See, in the internship program, you're supposed to behave like an assistant teacher, because you're learning various things. Whenever you are in contact with the school teacher, आपको सभी उनसे contact में रहकर सभी चीजें करनी है. So simultaneously, you supposed to take guidance from your mentor, or you can say the teacher educator, isn't it? Okay, now I'm going to share my screen. The screen is visible for everyone. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. I think Darshana, ma'am, she has taken orientation about this course code 207 BA 207. That is nothing but
no, ma'am.
No, because
no, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. She asked Vikas Tupsundar sir, and he was telling that she took two times orientation about the 20.
No, actually, we came to know that every teacher took orientation about their own.
No, in the month of August, I think, because in the first week of month of August, there were orientation, okay, sessions, yes, of the different heads. So you might have missed that sessions. Okay. I don't know that. Okay, let
Maybe.
It be. I'm here for
okay,
you.
Ma'am.
Okay, so let's start with the orientation of the internship program. That is nothing but the teaching competency 4. See the credits given here. See, these are the credits. Total 8 credits are there, and the duration is 16 weeks. 16 means it is approximately 4 months. So internship for the second year, it is for the 4 months. And see the marks. This is very, very important, because from the 1000 marks, 200 marks for the internship program only. Okay. See, so internship means what? It is expected that student teachers, means you people, are exposed to a varieties of approaches. So which approaches? It is teaching. It is observation of the children in the multiple socio-cultural environment, or you can say socio-economic environment. So as you know, the different, you can see different students are there. They came from the different socio-economic backgrounds. So this internship, it gives you the exposure to directly approach with the students. Okay. And one more thing is there, after completion of the internship, you should reflect about the entire internship program. Okay. One more thing it is that is student teachers means you people should engage themselves, means you should engage yourself in the CCE. CCE means what? Can anybody tell me full form of CCE? Yes? You have already learned this in the evaluation. Just try to recall.
Continuous.
Yes, very, very true. Very nice, Pooja.
Continuous comprehensive evaluation.
Yes. Continuous comprehensive evaluation. Okay. So it can be, so it is possible whenever there is a formative as well as summative evaluation. Now tell me meaning of the formative and summative evaluation. Yes. What do you mean by
formative evaluation? Means unit test wise, first test you can say unit test, and summative means as a whole at the end of the year we can say like annual exam or half yearly exam.
Okay, but if
I'm
okay, that is summative. Okay, suppose I'm asking questions. See, we are talking about the continuous comprehensive evaluation. Suppose while taking any lecture in any class, suppose I'm asking some developmental questions. So it comes under which kind of evaluation? Even at the end of the lesson. At the end of the lesson, you're asking some questions, the question of evaluation. You're also asking some questions for the application based questions you're asking. So all these questions comes under which type of evaluation?
Formative evaluation.
Yes, excellent. It is formative evaluation. But suppose, see, you are very true. That is whenever we are evaluating student after the particular period of time. So the time duration it should be more. That evaluation it is nothing but the summative evaluation. Okay. If we see in your internship program, total 6 activities are there. Okay. And you should plan and see while preparing this internship program here, what they are expecting, you can take guidance from the school teachers and your teacher educators as well. Okay. So you have to work all 4 months under the guidance or under the supervisor of the school teacher and the teacher educator. Teacher educator means who? Your mentor. It's me. Okay. Understood about this? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. See, this is the actual index page of your internship journal. Means what you supposed to do throughout this 4 months duration. Okay. So if we see the journal, first you write about the acknowledgement, then you write the brief introduction about the internship. You have to enlist different objectives of the internship. And there are 6 activities included in your internship program. So these are the activities. Block teaching. So in block teaching, you're supposed to conduct total 6 lessons, means 3 lessons of each method. Okay. Now, let me clear you. You're having total 3 methods, which means for practice teachings, you took 2 lessons of each method, 2 plus 2 plus 2, total 6. But here, what I told you have to conduct total 6 lessons, that is of 2 methods, 3 plus 3 is equal to 6. Means the third method you are having, it is compulsory to take 3 lessons of the third method, and from first 2 methods, you can select any one method. Understood about this? Yes or no? For example,
yes,
in the first year, my methods are science and mathematics.
Yes,
and
ma'am.
Second year, my third method is biology. Okay. So the biology is compulsory for me, but the previous 2 methods, I have choice. I can select any one method. But I will suggest you, if you are having third method, that is biology, it is more equal to the science. So you can, instead of selecting science, just select mathematics subjects, because it will give you varieties in your lesson planning, isn't it? Then the second activity, that is unit plan, blueprint, and screen is visible to everyone? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
See, in the second activity, what you're supposed to do, unit planning should be there, blueprint should be there, and unit test. You have already learned all these things in your 104, that is evaluation paper, right? Then the third activity, it is regarding to report on any one school records, any four school records. So it's your choice. You can select any four school records and you have to write report and on that. Then the fourth activity, that is co-curricular activities. You have to select any four and five co-curricular activities. The fifth one, that is observation of peers. See, again, the number of lessons, that is six lessons. Just compare this with the A, that is block teaching. So in block teaching, you're supposed to conduct total six lessons. And again, there are observations of peers of six lessons. Means, for example, suppose I'm going to take block teaching for mathematics and biology. So I will conduct three lessons of mathematics and three lessons of biology. Okay. So whatever methods I have selected for black block teaching, the same methods I should do observation of the same methods of my peer mates. For example, Ranjita, she is also having the same methods. She also selected the same methods. See, it is not necessary that you have to observe only one person. It's your choice. For example, Ranjita, she is having mathematics. So I can observe. See, here it is compulsory for you. You have to observe all three lessons of any one method of Ranjita. Suppose I have selected mathematics. So I am supposed to observe all three lessons of Ranjita for mathematics subject. Suppose my next method I have selected, that is biology. That is my third method, but it is compulsory for me. So for biology, suppose Pooja, she is having biology subject and she took the biology method. Okay. So again, the same thing. I have to observe all three lessons of biology of Pooja only. ऐसे नहीं हो सकता कि मैंने पूजा का बायोलॉजी का एक लेसन ऑब्जर्व किया, फिर स्मिता के बायोलॉजी के दो लेसन ऑब्जर्व किए. ऐसे नहीं हो सकता. यू हैव टू ऑब्जर्व ऑल थ्री लेसन ऑफ द सेम मेथड ऑफ द सेम पर्सन. इज इट क्लियर फॉर ऑल? यस
यस मैम.
यस मैम.
देन नेक्स्ट इज अदर स्कूल एक्टिविटीज. यू हैव टू कंडक्ट एनी वन एक्टिविटी अंडर दिस हेड. Actually, if we see manual given by the university, in that the various activities enlisted there, but our college has selected these two activities. And now again you are having choice here, but I will request you, because of this pandemic situation, it is not possible to conduct community related work activity. So we'll go for the academic calendar. Okay, so you can say that now this is the academic calendar, preparation of academic calendar. It is the compulsory activity for you all. Okay, then next is, see, these are your six activity you supposed to conduct, and these are the writing part you supposed to write before writing this activity reports, or you can say the lesson plans. And these are the, see, the day wise program or activities. You can say the whatever things you are doing daily, it should be enlisted at the end of the journal. Then there is one attendance sheet you supposed to sign over there. Then after that, you supposed to write educational implications of the internship program. And last, there is second last, there is a reflection. You have to give reflection about whatever your opinions about the internship program, what you experienced during the 4 months, you can give a reflection at the end. And then lastly, there should be photo gallery. Okay, understood about this? Yes or no? Should I move ahead?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Good. See, we'll start with the first. The first is acknowledgement. Acknowledgement means what? Yes. Tell me fast. Yes. Acknowledgement means what? Acknowledgement means what? See, I have displayed one. Yes. Yes. Acknowledgement.
So thanks and gratitude to the person ahead of the
time to show our gratitude to. So to whom we supposed to show our gratitude? To whom we supposed to acknowledge?
Head of the school. The head of the school who is cooperating us.
Yes. Only head of the school. He see this entire.
No, our head of the school, our mentor, and teachers.
See, you should appreciate your school principal, even the school teachers, even yes. school students also. Because sometimes while conducting different activity, you should tell, you should take help of the students also. You should acknowledge to your mentor. You should acknowledge the college principal. There are so many persons. Even
yes.
you can acknowledge yes. your peer mates. You can see your college mates, okay, because they yes. are also helping. Because this internship, it is not for the single student, it is for the group of the students, okay. Then next, you should write the brief introduction about the internship. So I have just displayed some internship. You can use this also. You can add your own points also, okay. The internship program is designed to provide students engaged in the field experience, okay, with an opportunity to share their insights, to explore the links between students' academic preparation and the fieldwork. In short, this paragraph is telling us about the linking between the theory and the practical. So here what you are getting? You are getting direct experience, or you can say the field experience. Then the next is, as a part of internship experience, students are expected to take an active role in finding an appropriate internship for themselves. See, what you are expecting, you should take active participation throughout this 4 months program. Okay, so whatever introduction is there regarding the internship program, you can write it by your own. So these are the objectives. Whatever objectives I have enlisted here, you can write all these objectives as it is. Who will read this objective? Yes.
Ma'am, may I?
Yes, please.
Objective of the internship: to enable the student teacher A to develop lesson plans and conduct lessons. Then B to develop a plan of evaluation for the unit taught. Then third point, to know the various types of records are prepared and maintained in the school. Fourth one, to organize co-curricular and extracurricular activities in the school. Fifth one, to appear, give feedback, and reflect on the lessons given by peers. F, to get a feel of total experience of teaching in the school.
Okay, so all these are the objective. I think one thing is, whatever objective given in the manual, I have enlisted all the objective as it is. See, this meeting will end in 10 minutes. So immediately you can join the second meeting, isn't it?
Okay.
Upgrade now to remove 40 minutes time. Okay. See, to develop lesson plans and conduct lessons. Now tell me, just recall the first two activities. In the first two activities, you suppose the first activity was the block teaching, and the second activity was that is relating the unit planning, or you can say the evaluation of the students. So one thing is there, that is unit planning. So what you should do the first? You should do the first unit planning or the lesson planning?
Lesson planning.
Okay, lesson planning. Who is saying that lesson planning? Okay, we'll see later. To develop plan of evaluation for the unit taught. So here what we are expecting, you have to develop the plan of evaluation, means you have to prepare the unit test, and for preparing unit test, there should be blueprint. Okay. I'm not able to see my screen in between. Is it visible?
Yes,
for you?
Ma'am. Your screen is not.
Okay.
Wait. It is not visible, ma'am.
I'm going to stop my screen sharing and we'll share it again. Now it is visible, yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So here, what you're supposed to do, you have to prepare the unit test. And for preparation of the unit test, you have to prepare the blueprint. Okay. The third objective, to know the various types of school records prepared and maintained in the school. So here, for school records, you can take some examples of registers also. Okay, like muster register, we can say attendance register, we can say. So here you have to just know various types of record, and total 4 records you have to select here. Then you have to organize co-curricular and extracurricular activities in the school. So here total 4 activities you supposed to organize in your selected school. Then say the second last is peer observation, that is related to peer observation. See, here you have to observe your peer mate, you have to give feedback, and you have to give reflection on the lesson given by your peer mate. Okay. And the last one, to get feel of total experience of the teaching in the school, that is nothing but the whatever reflection you are going to write at the end of the journal, that is nothing but your whatever experience you are getting throughout these 4 months, that you're supposed to write in the at the last of the internship journal. Understood about the objectives? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. See, total 8 credits are there for the internship program. Three credits for block teaching, so it means for the 6 lessons. 1 credit for unit plan with blueprint, 1 credit for the records, 1 credit for co-curricular activities, 1 credit for peer observation, and 1 credit for the school activities. So total this head for the 200 marks, and this first head, that is for the 3 credit, that is nothing but the block teaching, it is for the 75 marks, and the remaining heads for the 25 marks. So the 5 into 25, that is 125 plus 75, sum total, that is 200. So this total head is for the 200 marks. Okay. See, after completion of this activity, in short, you can say after completion of this 4-month internship program, there is a post activity stage, and in the post activity stage, we supposed to conduct, we are going to conduct your presentations that can be group wise or it can be school wise. Okay, so be ready for that also. Whatever activities you are going to take throughout the 4 months of this internship program, you have to write every detail in the presentation about your activities. Okay, understood about this?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, we have 5 minutes time. I think I will finish the block teaching. See, in the total how many activities are there? Total 6 activities are there. In that activity, that is first activity, that is nothing but the block teaching. In that, you're supposed to conduct 6 lessons, 3 credits, 75 marks. The student teacher will select 1 unit from school subject in the consultation with the school teacher and the faculty. See, who is giving you the unit? The faculty members, or you can say the school teachers. She or he will prepare the lesson plan for that unit. She will teach that unit for at least 3 periods under the guidance and observation of school teacher or school educator. But here we are expecting that the school teacher, she is observing your lesson. We are expecting that only. So I'm not going to observe your lessons. So whatever remarks are there, you're supposed to submit all the remarks to me. So later on, I will just write all the remarks. Okay. The same shall be repeated for the other school subject. That is nothing but the second method you have selected. Okay. So for example, first method I have selected science, and second method, so not science, mathematics, and second method, that is nothing but the biology methods. So lesson shall be conducted at upper primary, secondary, and higher secondary. Means 6 to 12th standard, we can conduct this block teaching lessons. Okay. See, what do you understand by this? Here, we supposed to we have to prepare a lesson plan for that unit. See, what is written here? Lesson plan for that unit. And we supposed to teach that unit at least in the 3 periods. Means what? What do you understand by this? Yes?
The whole lesson will be divided into 3 periods, 3 classes.
Okay.
And prepare 3 lesson plan, and that will be under the appear by the school teacher.
Yes, very nice, Ranjita. So how we can select that lesson?
The class teacher will provide that one, the subject teacher.
Yes, class teacher, but before that, you should tell your the class teacher, or you can say the subject teacher, that I need a lesson which I can teach in 3 periods. Okay, yes, so accordingly yes, that you can important. Yes, accordingly you can okay, teacher can give you particular lessons. For example, I have selected one lesson of 10th standard. Okay, and the unit name is the magic of chemical reactions. So here is the unit name of the unit. And first, what we supposed to do? You have to do content analysis of that unit. आपको सबसे पहले देखना है कि वो unit में क्या-क्या content है. So if we see the total main four subunits are there, that is chemical equations, types of chemical reactions, oxidation and reduction, and neutralization. So just see the scope of these particular subunits, and then decide for particular period of time which subunit you can select. It should be in the proper sequence. For example, so I have divided this. See, I have divided this. This is the content analysis, and I have divided this content in three parts. The first, in the first period, I will teach chemical equations. In the second, types of chemical reactions, and in the third, oxidation and reduction and neutralization. Okay. So here I wrote the first period, second period, and third period. So what do you mean by I supposed to conduct? Supposed to teach one unit in three periods. First, second, and third period means what? Yes, I want answers from your side. Yes, Neelam, Ujwala, Rohini, what do you mean by first, second, and third period?
3 days, three periods.
Okay.
One second? Period in one day.
Yes, ma'am. According to me, that is same.
Yes, one period in means your concepts are clear. Okay. So there should not be, please listen, there should not be more gap between the two periods. For example, I'm taking first period of mathematics on Monday. Then second should be on the Tuesday, and third should be on the Wednesday. In between, you can take gap of one day. That is not an issue, but there should not be more gap. So better don't take any gap in between the days. Just try to conduct your lessons on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. On the successive days, you can conduct successive any days. Okay. So there should not be gaps. Don't conduct two lessons on the same day. Try to conduct one lesson on the one day. Okay. One day. Understood about this? Okay.
Yes.
See, before that, before moving.
मैम आप स्टार्ट करो, स्मिता को थोड़ा प्रॉब्लम है इलेक्ट्रिसिटी का.
ओके ओके, कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं. ठीक है, वंस अगेन गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन. ओके, वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द फर्स्ट एक्टिविटी ऑफ द इंटर्नशिप प्रोग्राम, सो लेट्स मूव अहेड टुवर्ड्स द सेकंड एक्टिविटी. द स्क्रीन इज विजिबल टू एवरीवन, यस और नो?
यस मैम.
Okay, Smita, she is going to admit. Good. Okay. See, the second activity, that is nothing but the plan of evaluation. Okay. So this activity is for one credit and it carries total 25 marks. See, I have highlighted something here. Unit plan, formative, summative, unit test, blueprint, model answer, and marking scheme. Okay. See, before preparing lesson plan, it's up to you. So it is expected that before preparing lesson plan, we supposed to prepare unit plan. So there is a format, I will show it later. Okay. So student teacher will prepare a unit plan providing formative. See, here the meaning of formative and summative evaluation, providing formative and summative evaluation. Formative means for each lesson plan, and summative evaluation means unit test after completion of the unit. So here in the block teaching, you supposed to teach one unit in the three lessons. Okay, and whatever questions you are going to ask at the end of the lessons based on the evaluation questions or the application based questions, that is nothing but the formative assessment. And at the end of the block teaching, you are supposed to take conduct unit test, that is nothing but the summative assessment. Okay, so here you have to prepare the unit test. Now tell me, how much gap should be there after, suppose you have completed your block teaching of one method, that is method maths. Okay, so on which day, suppose you have conducted your lessons on Monday, Tuesday and Wednesday, so on which day you will conduct your unit test of the students? Yes,
Indian Friday, Saturday.
Yes, there should not be more gap in between. Okay, so see, maximum give 1 or 2 days gap, don't give more than that. For example, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday you have completed your entire unit, then just give gap of 1 day or 2 days.
2 days gap.
Yes, 2 days gap, and conduct your test on the Friday or Saturday as per your planning. Okay, then see, before unit test there should be blueprint. So blueprint means what? Why there is a need of blueprint? Yes, tell me. I want interactive sessions. Try to
blueprint is nothing but a marking scheme. Marking scheme according to the questions.
No. Blueprint is not marking scheme. Marking scheme.
Unit test plan.
Yes, it is nothing but the unit test planning. So what we plan in the blueprint? Yes, Ranjita. Others, they also try to answer.
How to divide the unit for subjective question, objective question, like 2 marks question, 1 mark question and 5 mark question.
Yes, in your blueprint also you have to consider whatever content you are divided in 3 parts, just consider the content, and again that we have to take the examples, that is knowledge, understanding, application and skill. You have to consider all these 4 objective, and again the type of question, that is objective question, short answer question and essay type question. So will conduct unit test first or the blueprint first? Of course the blueprint first. It is nothing but the planning of the unit test. Okay, see, this is a format is given in your internship journal. So in the block teaching I have selected the unit, the magic of the chemical reactions. So how many columns are there? Total 4 columns are there. What to teach, why to teach, how to teach and evaluation. Okay, so what to teach, so in your unit planning also whatever content you are divided in 3 parts, you have to consider like that only. Okay, so for example chemical reactions, so like lesson planning, whatever lesson planning we did in the practice teaching, like that you have to write the objective and specification. So here knowledge, understanding, application, skills, it's up to you. So whatever objectives will fulfill in the particular content, just consider those objectives only. It is not possible to complete all the objectives at a time. Okay, the next is, the screen is visible to everyone, yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Not clearly, ma'am.
Just wait for a minute. Okay, instead of showing slideshow, I will directly use like this. Is it okay to you? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
It's okay, ma'am. No.
Okay, see, so here how to teach, that is nothing but the introduction. So what kind of learning experience, what activities you are going to take while teaching particular content, are you asking different questions in between for the development of the content, the entire things will come in this. So see here, how to teach means you have to write about the teaching learning experiences. So first you supposed to start with the introduction, how you introduce the particular topic by taking an activity, by asking questions, by showing different images, or by asking the comparison or the different questions on the images or the on the videos, etc. Okay, and again you have to write which method or which teaching method you are using in this. For example, suppose I am using this method, lecture come demo discussion method I am using. You can write the lecture come demonstration method you are using. Like this, you can write the teaching method. Then last is the evaluation questions. Again, the same, that is the questions, that is evaluation questions and application based questions you're supposed to ask here. So here it's up to you. For the application level, there are three types of questions. It is not necessary that only you supposed to ask objective type questions. You can ask any short length or short answer questions or the essay type questions for the application level. It's your choice. You can select any kind of question, but it should be based on the application level only. Then here is the educational aid. So whatever, now we are going to take virtual classes only. So here you can write the presentation, okay? A PPT presentation you can write. Understood about the unit planning? Yes or no? Yes. Okay, should we go ahead? Yes.
Yes.
See,
yes.
Here the activity, I wrote here the learning experiences. So I have displayed one activity in the next page. It was not possible to write over there. See, activity. Take a small piece of newspaper. Weigh it on an electric balance, which will be readily available in your nearby grocery shop. Burn the piece of paper and now weigh the ash. So what do you observe about the initial and final weights? What can you infer? See, so on the basis of this experiment, the student, they will do their inferences. Okay, so according to the law of conservation of mass, the total mass of the reaction is equal to the total mass of the product during the chemical reaction. So to make more simple, the number of atoms in each element remains same after, before and after the chemical reaction. So such type of activity you can take during. So now here you're supposed to take care of that you are teaching this lesson or teaching your methods virtually. So accordingly, you can select any activity. Okay. So next part of the second activity, that is nothing but the blueprint. So here I have displayed different images, the images of the car and the and house. Okay. So see, the this is the upper view, this is the side view, this is the front view, and this is the back view of the image. So here, while constructing anything, so here you are going to prepare a unit test. So we have to take care of each and everything. So we have to give equal weightage to the different subunits. So as we have selected the particular unit and we are going to teach the same unit in the three parts. So we have to give different weightage. As per the scope of the subunit, you have to give weightage for the unit. Okay. For example, suppose we are going to take a unit test of 20 marks. Okay. And total three subparts are there. You are going to teach the same unit in three parts. So for particular subpart, the weightage should be given. How much weightage should be given for the particular subpart? Yes. I want answer for your side. No interactions from your side. I think you all are feeling drowsy because just you have your lunch. Am I right? Yes.
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Tell me the answer. Suppose I'm going to, you're supposed to take your unit test for the 25 marks. And here we have divided the single unit in the three parts. So on particular subunit, on particular part, how much weightage should be given for the particular subunit or the particular part? The total question unit test is of 25 marks. Just divide 25 by 3. So it is not possible to ask questions on the 8.33 like this. Okay. So you can ask questions like 8 and 9
8.
As per the scope of the particular subunit. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. See, this is the blueprint which is given in your internship journal. So here, serial number 1, 2, 3, these are nothing but the content. So for the first period, you have selected this content, second, third. Just don't write anything here because only you have to finish your unit in the three parts only. So in knowledge, comprehension, application and skill, there are different questions, objective level, short answer and essay type questions. So you have to consider all these objectives. Okay. And all the subunits also, and total sum of the marks of the question should be 25. Okay, please see, I have written something here, that is 5-1. So what it indicates? Yes, can anyone try to answer?
5 questions of 1 mark.
Yes, I'm going to ask under the comprehensive, I'm going to ask 5 questions and which carries 1 mark each. Okay, so here, see, number inside the bracket, it indicates the number of, see, not I told exactly opposite. Number inside the bracket.
Yes, ma'am. It's an essay type question.
This is because this is essay type question and one question
having 5 marks.
Yes, I want to check whether you all are awake or not. Okay. So this is the 1 question is for the 5 marks.
5 marks.
This is the 1 blueprint. I took it from online. Again, the same thing here. According to them, this objective, very short answer and long answer. So you can say very short answer and long, instead of long answer, we can say essay type questions. Okay. They did the same thing. The number of questions should be inside the bracket and number of marks should be outside the bracket. This is the blueprint for the subject civics. See what kind of questions comes under the particular level of objective and the particular type of question. Okay. Here the student, he is making chart of fundamental duties. That is nothing but the skill. Okay. It comes under the which objective? Skill objective. And it comes under the essay type question. Then the second is, write any 4 qualities of a good citizen. So this is very basic level question. That is the knowledge level question. It comes under which type of question? Short answer question.
Perfect.
Okay. Whenever there is a differentiation between the 2 things, that is Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, it is understanding. It again comes under short answer question. Now tell me, one who lives in India permanently is called the --- of the country. Tell me the answer first and then tell me the it comes under which type of question. The objective is, it is knowledge level questions, and in knowledge level there are 3 types of questions: objective, short answer and essay type questions. Now tell me the type of question here.
So objective type question.
Objective type and citizen of our country.
Citizen of our country.
Yes, the answer is citizen of our country and it comes under the objective type questions. Very nice. See, the next is application. Okay. Even in application, you can give the different type of questions, objective, short answer and essay type questions. So here, see the pattern of the questions, how the questions are asked. How will you avoid occurrence of accident? Of course, this is a application based question. So whatever knowledge he is gaining, whatever things he understanding about the particular content, the same thing the student is going to apply. So he's giving his opinion. How will you avoid occurrence of accident? But it comes under the short answer questions. Okay. How will you be eligible for voting? Again, this is application. See the how, just turn your, what you can say. Here we supposed to ask WH questions. Just what you can say, the switch your question. And you can make, you can change the level of objective. Okay. How can you be the member of Lok Sabha? That is also application based question, and on all these questions they comes under short answer question. See, again, these are the questions, they comes under knowledge, and all these questions, they are the objective level questions. See, this is the understanding and the question type is objective type. So you should understand the difference between the different level of objective and the types of question. Red light indicate that we should walk, we should move. See, so this is the understanding. When the student is got understanding of the particular content, then and then only he can able to solve the question. So the objective is understanding, and the type of question, that is nothing but the objective question. Same thing regarding this. A 10-year-old boy doesn't have the right to education, walk, standing live, vote. Okay, so this is also, the answer is vote. Very true. and it comes under objective type question. See, knowingly I added different slides here because you should understand the difference between the different objectives, or you can say the level of objective, and how you can write different types of questions regarding the particular objective. Means for application, if I want to write the question that is objective questions, how you can write. For that I have displayed some more slides. See, understanding, application, these are the levels of objective, and all questions comes under objective type questions. If you want this presentation, I will share it with you. Otherwise, I will directly upload this video on YouTube, so you'll get everything there. Okay.
Please.
Okay. See, please keep in mind, it differs as per the organization, as per the universities. But here we supposed to follow the question paper pattern 60-40. See, we have to consider the scope of the unit, sub-unit, and accordingly that we have to give the different weightage to the unit. But here, what we are supposed to do, we have to follow the pattern 60-40. Means 60% weightage should be given for the knowledge and comprehension, and 40% weightage should be given for the application and skill-based question. Understood about this? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Huh?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, good. Again, this is the last part of your second activity, that is B, unit test. See, you're supposed to prepare the blueprint, and your unit test should be based on the blueprint. So how it should be, just I gave heading here, don't write unit test here. You just start your unit test with your school name, then write unit test, name of the unit, time, maximum marks. You're supposed to conduct your test for the 25 marks, how many questions are included there, and write the date. Okay, and you can add some more things that obtain marks like this. Okay, instructions are compulsory. Whatever instructions are there regarding your test, you're supposed to list all the instructions here. Like all questions are compulsory, figures in the right indicate full marks, students should specifically follow the limitations of the word. If you are telling, you are giving the short answer question for the sixth class student, and what you are telling is to write your answer in the 8 to 10 lines or 10 to 15 lines. They're supposed to follow the limitations of the word, or instead lines, you can say the in the particular words, it up to you. Okay. See, while preparing this unit test, you can prepare like your whatever exam papers you are getting now, only the questions are there, but you can prepare your test so that students can write the answer in the same. Okay, so there should not be need of providing provision of the different answer sheet for the students. Okay, and there you should follow the particular format, like simple to complex.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Like for unit test, can we prepare like a Google form?
Don't worry about this. Actually, what happened? I discussed with the Rokade ma'am, and we have decided that it is not possible. You can also conduct that test.
Okay.
But as per your journal and as per the evaluation criteria, you supposed to follow the same format. Okay.
Okay.
So just prepare the blueprint. As per the blueprint, prepare the unit test. Okay. And if you want to conduct like MCQ type test or any, you can include all the, if it is possible for you to include all these, whatever questions you are included in your test, considering the blueprint, then you can use your Google form and you can conduct your student test also. That is not an issue. Okay. If it is possible, then please proceed. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Then see the third activity, that is understood about the second activity, that is unit planning, how to prepare unit plan, how to prepare blueprint, how to prepare unit test. Okay. And I think one more thing is there. Yes. You have to prepare model answer and marking scheme of the developed unit test. Means what? See, model answer means what? Whatever question paper or unit test you have prepared, you have to write question wise answers in proper way, in a proper sequence, that is nothing but your model answer. Okay. And marking scheme means what? Suppose you are going to ask what are the causes of pollution. Okay. So this question comes under understanding level. Okay. And in the short answer questions, if you see the type of question. So what you are expecting, the student is supposed to write four causes. See, four causes of the pollution. So as per your marking scheme, you are giving 2 marks for each question. So that is nothing but your marking scheme. Understood about the marking scheme? So our objective questions are there. So 1 mark for each question. Then suppose subjective questions are there. So how you are going to divide the marks? Suppose the particular question, essay type question, is for the 6 marks. So how you are going to divide the 6 marks? What you are expecting there? Okay. So you have to give each and every details regarding your marking scheme over there. Okay. Understood about this? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Then next is study of the records maintained by the school. It is also a 1 credit for 25 marks. So it is basically to understand you people about the administrative aspect of the school life. Okay. And you should realize the need and maintenance of the records and their importance in the smoothly functioning of the any organization, or we can say school. So here we supposed to select 4 records. Maintained by the only 4 records you supposed to select. The total marks are 25. It will be converted into, see, mark calculated out of 25 only, except the first activity, that is the block teaching. The remaining all activities, they are having 25 marks. Final conversion is out of 25 marks. See, I have displayed some images of the register, like admission register is there, purchase register is there. This is the stock register. Okay. See, you have selected 4 register. Now this is the format, how to write report on this activity, that is activity number 3. Okay. So here you're supposed to write the introduction about the school records. Why there is a need and importance of school records. Again, you have to prepare objectives of this activity. I think 2 or 4 objectives, they are more than enough. Then record wise, you have to write the report, write the title of the record. Then you have to display the format. You have to take picture of that record and display the format, or just take picture of that format on your journal. Then style of maintaining, just explain about that. In the nature and scope, again, the same thing. You have to explain what different columns are there, what is there, what particular things they are maintaining in the particular registers, how they are maintaining. You have to write each and every detail about the register. Then it is related to student. It is related to, suppose the teacher student attendance register, it is there. So of course it is related to the student. The muster is there, it is related to the teacher. Suppose the admission register is there, it is related to the institution. So as per the, you have to write that the particular register is related to the student or teacher or institution, etc. And on the particular record, you have to give your own opinion also. The same criteria you supposed to follow for the remaining 3 records. Understood about this? So you have to start the report writing of this 3rd activity with the introduction, need and importance, objective of the activity. Then write report of each activity separately. And at the end of this, you have to write educational implication of this activity. And see, overall impression, it is for us. So don't write overall impression, just write only educational objectives. Okay. We have only last 10 minutes. Okay. Then the 4th activity, that is nothing but the curricular and co-curricular activity, which is also having for 1 credit and 25 marks. So basically it is to enhance the organizational and managerial skills in the student teacher. So see, which type of activity, it's up to you. Just think the activities which you can, it is possible for you to conduct virtually, and activities you can conduct in your group. अगर रंजिता का ग्रुप है सपोज 3 students आर देयर दे कैन कंडक्ट द पर्टिकुलर एक्टिविटी इन द ग्रुप देयर इज नो नीड टू कंडक्ट डिफरेंट करिकुलर एंड को करिकुलर एक्टिविटीज इंडिविजुअली आई एम रिपीटिंग दिस अगेन देयर इज नो नीड ऑफ कंडक्शन ऑफ करिकुलर को करिकुलर एंड एक्स्ट्रा करिकुलर एक्टिविटीज इंडिविजुअली यू कैन कंडक्ट दिस एक्टिविटीज इन अ ग्रुप ओके अंडरस्टूड अबाउट दिस ओके And final conversion, it is of out of 25. See, this is very important. Observations of the peers. You have to observe lessons of your peer mates. So whatever methods you have selected for the block teachings, you should observe the same methods of your peer mates of block teaching. Plus means total 3+3, total 6 method you supposed to observe. See, I will share it later or I will mail it to you. Okay, so there is specific criteria. While observation, the first evaluation table is there, that is for the teacher educator, means for us. The second evaluation table is there, that is for you. Means you are going to assess your peer mate quantitatively, that table is for you. And there is a one page. So you have to give the qualitative assessment of your peer mate. So how you can write that? You're supposed to write, she did introduction of this topic by asking these questions. She took one activity regarding this, what kind of learning experiences she gave. So like this, you have to write the quantitative assessment of your peer mate. Okay. Understood about this? I will share the internship journal to you. Okay. So you'll get the entire idea how to conduct the internship program. Okay. And the last activity, that is nothing but the other school activities. I have already told you about this. So under this, we have selected the academic calendar activity. And here, please listen carefully because you have to prepare the academic calendar for only 4 months, not for the entire academic year. Actually, as per the planning, every school prepared academic calendar for the particular year, we can say. But here we supposed to prepare your academic calendar only for the 4 months. How many months? For the 4 months. So whatever activities you are taking, suppose you are taking your block teaching, you are doing peer observations, you are doing, you are conducting any co-curricular activities, you are planning something. So whatever you are planning, everything should be reflected on your academic calendar. If school is going to organize anything extra, each and every activity should be there in your academic planning. Okay, understood about this? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
See, yes, ma'am. I have displayed one format here. So you can use, see, the date is up to you. You can select any format, whichever, whatever you like. This is for the June month. So you can consider your 4 months like October, November, December and January. Okay. Then day wise you are supposed to write. Suppose I have a plan. What you plan? Block teaching you have plan. Okay. So block teaching you took permission. You take unit from the teacher. Okay. Then you prepare a unit planning. Then you prepare a lesson planning for a particular subject. So whatever you are doing, just write each and everything here. So that is nothing but your planning. So already you have planned about your 4 months. Okay. So that is nothing but your academic calendar. Actually, this is related to the students only, but you can add your own activities in this calendar. Understood about this? Yes or no? Okay. And later on, you're supposed to write the day-wise program activities, attendance sheet, educational implications of the internship program, your reflection, and lastly, photo gallery. So, see, always take screenshot. So, whatever you are going to take virtually, it can be any co-curricular activity, it can be any your block teaching lecture, it can be any test. So please take screenshots because it is very needed for maintaining the photo gallery. Okay. Now I'm going to stop screen sharing. Still we are having 3 or 4 minutes. So in shortly, I will tell you about the, just wait for a while. Okay. It is visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
See, this is your internship journal. And I am showing you the last pages of the journal so that you will get idea. And accordingly, you can maintain all the records related to internship program. See, this is the criteria of the peer observations. See, this is the first sheet. It is for us, for your teacher educators. So you can see your mentors. The second sheet, it is for you. You're supposed to write. Suppose I'm going to observe the lesson of mathematics of my peer mate Rohini. So I can write her name, her roll number. So how she did her introduction. So what, see, this, the points are same. Whatever points we are already used for evaluating your lessons, the points are same. So you can just write tick marks over here and just calculate the total marks. Suppose she got the quantitatively, you evaluate Rohini's lesson and she got 85 marks. Okay. You can give quantitative feedback for her. And the next it is the feedback observation of the same. Matlab, यहाँ पे रोहिणी का ही लेसन ऑब्जर्व करना है सेम लेसन बट हियर द फीडबैक शुड बी गिवन इन द क्वांटिटेटिव नॉट क्वांटिटेटिव इट इज यू शुड बी इन द क्वालिटेटिव फॉर्म सो यू कैन जस्ट राइट अबाउट द इंट्रोडक्शन शी स्टेट देम एंड व्हाट काइंड ऑफ लर्निंग एक्सपीरियंसेस शी हैज गिवन हाउ शी इवैल्यूएटेड द स्टूडेंट ओके वेदर शी गॉट सक्सीड इन अचीवमेंट ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्टिव व्हाट एवर ही प्लान हिज हर ऑब्जेक्टिव इन द बिगिनिंग ऑफ द लेसन सो एवरीथिंग शुड बी रिटर्न हियर Okay, so again the same six lessons you supposed to observe of your peer mate 3+3 or whatever methods you have selected. The same lessons you have to observe of your peer mate. Okay. See, this is your. You can write your daily, like see, suppose the week number one, here you're supposed to write day-wise activity. So whatever things you are doing throughout the 4 months, you have to keep record day-wise. For example, serial number one, day, date and day. Suppose the 1st October and day was suppose Monday, you can say. So what you did, which activity you have completed? You can write anything if you plan, if you took permission, if you check your lesson plan for your mentor, from the school teachers, if you assist any teacher in the school work. So whatever you did in the 4 months, you can just write each and everything in the day wise activity. This is very, very important. See, like this, you have to maintain day wise record for the 4 months. And see here, you have to just supposed to sign, write the date, day, and just sign. This is your attendance sheet. And at the end of the each page, there is a sign of school observer teacher and sign of group in charge. So you have to maintain your attendance sheet for the all 4 months. So you have to be supposed to start with the 1st of October and it will end on the 31st of January. Okay. I'm going to share my screen again. Just wait for a while.
Gracias.
See attendance sheet. After attendance sheet, so this is the attendance sheet for the 4 months. Then there is a next, that is educational implications of the internships. You can write educational implications of internship in paragraph wise, or you can just write bullets or point wise you can write. Then after writing educational implications, just you supposed to write reflection. So whatever things you experienced during the entire 4 month program, just write your reflection about the 4 month internship program. Okay, and this is the end of the your journal. And at last, just take different photographs of the different activities. If you are going to involve in the different activities, then it is important that you can also add different photographs of that activities. Okay, and I'm going to share, going to stop screen sharing. Okay, actually because of some technical issues, already we have recorded this part, but the last part of that meeting was not recorded. So I'm just doing recording of this part, so no participants are there. I'm just telling virtually. Okay, I wish you all the best for the internship program. Just try to give your level best. Okay, and we have conducted this meeting in 3-4 parts because it took 2 hours approximately. So I thanks everyone for patient listening me very patiently. Thank you so much. I'm going to end this meeting.